the Malabo Montpellier Forum, which 2 to 3 times a year brings high-level decision makers at the ministerial level from Africa and their development partners and non-state actors around the reports that the panel prepares and their findings to exchange. The events organized by the forum is the opportunity to ensure that leading policymakers have access to the latest evidence, that they have a good understanding of the intricacies, the nuances, the granularity of all the issues around strategic areas of capital importance for African agricultural development, for food security and for nutrition.
I was invited to co-chair the forum. Really, it's about service to fellow citizens back home, as well as fellow citizens of the continent. I accepted so that I could also, using my skills, offer service to the people of the continent and the people of Malawi back home.
Je crois que parce que c'est une bonne initiative, c'est une bonne plateforme, nous en avons besoin. Ce que ça a démontré, c'est l'utilité d'une telle plateforme, et je pense que je dirais aux organisateurs, il faut continuer, et personnellement, je suis prêt à participer aux prochaines éditions de ce forum. Il y a encore trop d'enfants qui ne mangent pas à leur faim, il y a encore trop d'enfants qui mangent mal, il y a encore trop d'enfants qui n'ont pas le poids suffisant, il y a encore trop d'enfants qui ne grandissent pas suffisamment, et donc nous avons des défis à relever. Mais en même temps, nous constatons que beaucoup parmi nous ont fait des efforts qui ont payé. Ils ont des résultats. Il y a des gens, des pays qui ont eu des efforts, qui ont eu des résultats extraordinaires. Nous avons appris de cela, et ce qui est important en ce qui concerne cette politique, c'est d'apprendre de ces pays qui ont réussi, ce qui a marché, et de voir comment nous pouvons les dupliquer dans nos pays.
I think the forum is quite substantive, and the partnership of governments in Africa and the presence of the highest level of leadership, the Vice President of Malawi and senior leadership of Benin, the Minister of Planning and Development, the Minister of Agriculture, and the policymakers within Benin and other African countries enrich the discourse, the exchanges and the dialogues and sharing of best practices based on facts and evidence to ensure that the findings of the nutrition report continues to be shared and to sensitize all the players within the agri ecosystems.
I think what we've seen is that the approach that the panel takes is one of accepting the challenge and then identifying success stories and instances when people have managed to overcome those challenges so that other African governments can learn from the success that they've seen. So it has a very much a forward-looking, positive approach, and it's deeply grounded in the latest technical research. So those aspects, along with this sort of bringing together of governments and researchers, are the things that make me excited about the panels.
The advocacy of evidence-based decision-making is going to be more and more critical as we listen to different countries, different geographies sharing their own success stories. And based on those, obviously, we adopt things that are going to work in our respective countries.
We should really be talking about transformative agendas, transformative actions, wide impact actions. And there comes in digital technology to help us scale up very quickly, very fast, very cost efficient, and using large numbers of farmers. And when I think through about what needs to be done, personally I'm convinced that we need to bet it on the new generation. If we focus on the new generation, increasing awareness, understanding, providing information about what this means and what are the impacts if it is not addressed, I think it's a very good investment.
Looking at the progression from subsistence farming to more commercial. So at that point, you introduce the topic of mechanization. Productivity per hectare, of course, looking at the cost as well, will be better with mechanization. As we upscale subsistence farmers from the traditional ways of farming to more mechanization, the yield and therefore the earnings are also going to improve. These two parts, the food security and the mechanization, are the key discussions that we are looking at here.